it's a new week, so that means a new interactive notebook page. So we're going to need our scissors, our glue stick, our writing utensil, our interactive notebook sheet, and our interactive notebook. Let's go ahead and let's open to the next clean sheet in your interactive notebook for us to work on. It should be the next page, ready to go. We're gonna start off like we do all the time, cutting around the dark border perimeter of each piece, cutting on the solid black lines. All right, when you're finished, just put your trash off to the side. You'll deal with it later. So now you should have your title card. You should have your step-by-step instructions, and you should have your adding and subtracting practice for the bottom. We're gonna first start off with your title card with adding and subtracting decimals. So go ahead and flip that over and get your glue stick, and let's glue that to the top of your page. Right up here at the top. All right. The next thing you want to grab is your step-by-step sheet with your two expressions that we're going to solve. You're going to need your scissors. We're going to cut on the solid black line so that we're able to flip the strips up to write our steps. Once you have your little flaps all cut out, you're going to glue on the back of this equation side. So let's flip it over. You're going to put your glue on the back where your equations are. And we're going to place this directly underneath the title card. So now you have your flaps ready to flip up when needed. Now we're going to take the add or subtract little pentagon at the bottom. We're going to glue behind where it says add or subtract. So let's flip that over. We're going to glue inside where it says add and subtract. And we're going to place it directly underneath the little equations step by step at the bottom. All right. Now that we have our interactive notebook set all set up, we can place our scissors and glue off to the side. Let's start filling out our interactive notebook page, starting at the top with the step-by-step instructions. So we're going to start off with step number one. When you add or subtract decimals, what you're going to do first is you're going to rewrite your equations vertically, lining up your decimals. And that is an exclamation point. So let's go ahead and let's do step number one for both of these equations, lining up the decimals. So I'm going to put my decimal points and I'm going to rewrite both of my numbers vertically, making sure to line up with my decimals. So I'm going to do 32 and 60 hundredths. Again, going to my next number, which is 4 and 8 tenths. Make sure to put which equation you're doing, and we're doing addition for this one. I'm going to do the same thing with my subtraction equation at the bottom, 96 and 5 tenths minus 15 and 23 hundredths. So I'm going to rewrite this equation, lining up my decimals, 96 and 5 tenths minus 15 and 23 hundredths. Now you'll probably notice that there are some missing spots in our equation. So our second step that we're going to do is we are going to write place holder zeros for any missing place values. So for 4 8/10, I'm going to add my zero. So now it's 4 80/100. So now I can add these correctly. Same thing with 96 5/10. I'm going to add my zero. So it's 96 5/100. Now that we have our equations to where they're set up properly, with step number three, you're going to add, oops, sorry y'all, you're going to add or subtract, making sure to borrow or regroup. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm just going to work out my equation. Starting with my addition sentence, I'm going to start in my lowest place value first. Let's make that note up here. Start with your lowest place value. So I'm going to start in my hundredths first. So I'm going to go 0 + 0, that is 0. Now I'm going to add 6 + 8. Remember, start with your highest and then count up the next amount. So that's 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. So keep your 4 down here. Bring up your 1 to the next place value. 1 + 2 is 3. 3 + 4 is 7. Now we're going to do our tens. 3 + 0. 3 + 0 is 3. Now we're going to bring down our decimal point. So now we have our final sum, which is 37 40/100. I'm going to do the same thing down here, except now I'm doing subtraction. So in this case, I'm going to need to make sure that I borrow appropriately. I cannot subtract 0 - 3, but I can subtract 5 - 2. So I'm going to borrow from the 5. That becomes a 4, my 0 becomes a 10. 10 - 3 is 7, 4 - 2 is 2. So now I'm gonna move on, make sure to bring down your decimal point. Now I'm gonna go ahead and continue. I can subtract 6 - 5, 6 - 5 is 1, and I can subtract 9 - 1, 9 - 1 is 8. Your last and final step, I kind of already did. That is make sure to bring down your decimal point. Because without your decimal point, you're basically saying you have 3,740. So you need to make sure to bring down your decimal points where they need to be. All right, now that we have your steps filled out and you have your practice problems all on the side, now it's time for your turn. Go ahead and solve these 5 problems, writing your work underneath each of the tabs. I'm going to give you a couple of minutes to work through those and then come back to check your answers. All right, I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to start with 3 24/100 plus 4 9/10. So I'm going to write my work underneath. First, I'm going to rewrite my problem vertically. So I'm going to do 3 24/100 plus 4 9/10. Now, as step 2 told me before, I'm going to place any zeros for placeholders for any digits that are missing. So I'm going to put a 0 underneath my 4. So now my 4 9/10 have turned into 4 9/100. I'm going to add, starting in my lowest place value, which is my hundredths. So I'm going to go ahead and add. 4 + 0 is 4. 9 + 2 is 11. I keep my 1. regroup and bring that 10 tenths over and make 1, 1. 4 plus 3 is 7 plus 1 is 8. Make sure to bring down your decimal point. Your final sum is 8 and 14 hundredths. All right, I'm gonna go ahead and move over to 5. Sorry, I'm gonna flip it this way. 5 and 231 thousandths minus 2 and 6 tenths. I'm going to rewrite my equation vertically. So that's 5 and 231 thousandths minus 2 and 6 tenths. I'm gonna put my placeholder zeros for any missing digits. That way I can make 2 and 6 tenths, 2 and 6 thousandths. Now I'm going to solve. 1 minus 0 is 0. 3 minus 0 is 3. Oh, 1 minus 0 is 1. 3 minus 0 is 3. I cannot subtract 2 minus 6, so I have to borrow from my next highest place value. This 5 becomes a 4. This 2 becomes a 12. 12 minus 6 is 6. 4 minus 2 is 2. So that means the difference that you are going to get is 2 and 631 thousandths. All right, moving on. We're going to do 73 and 946 thousandths plus 293 and 42 hundredths. Again, rewrite it vertically. So we're going to do 73 and 946 thousandths plus 293 and 42 hundredths. Place any zeros for any missing place values and solve. Six, starting in your lowest place value. 6 plus 0 is 6, 4 plus 2 is 6, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, that is 13. Keep your 3, bring up your 1. 3 plus 3 is 6, plus 1 is 7. 9 plus 7, that is 16. Bring up your 1. 2 plus 1 is 3. Make sure to bring down your decimal point. So that means your final sum is 367 and 366 thousandths. Second to last, let's go ahead and do 640 and 1 tenth minus 3 and 289 thousandths. Again, rewrite your problem vertically. So that's 640 and 1 tenth minus 3 and 289 thousandths. Place your placeholder zeros for any missing digits. And now we're going to solve. Starting in my lowest place value first. I cannot subtract 0 minus 9, so I'm going to go to my next place value. I can't subtract 0 minus 8, so let's go to the next one. Cannot subtract 1 minus 2. Can't subtract 0 minus 3, but I can subtract 4 minus 0. So I'm going to borrow from my 4 that turns into a 3. My 0 turns into a 10, but since I have to borrow from my next place value, I'm going to borrow 1, that 10 becomes a 9. Letting this 1 become an 11, but I have to borrow from the 11 to give to my next place value. This becomes a 10 to make this 0 a 10. But I have to borrow one more time, so this 10 becomes a 9, this 0 becomes a 10. Now I'm going to go ahead and subtract. 10 minus 9 is 1, 9 minus 8 is 1, 10 minus 2 is 8. Bring down my decimal. 9 minus 3 is 6, 3 minus 0 is 3, 6 minus 0 is 6. So your final difference would be 636 and 811 thousandths. Last but not least, we're going to do 459 minus 86 and 92 hundredths. Almost done. Rewrite your problem vertically. So that's 459 minus 86 and 92 hundredths. Remember, behind every whole number is a secret decimal zero. So you just need to add that extra zero for a placeholder. All right, now we're gonna go ahead and subtract. I can't subtract zero minus two, can't subtract zero minus nine, but I can subtract nine minus six. I'm gonna borrow from the nine. That turns this nine into an eight, turns this zero into a 10. But I have to borrow from this 10 to make this zero a 10, so this nine, this 10 becomes a nine, this zero becomes a 10. 10 minus 2 is 8. 9 minus 9 is 0. Bring down the decimal. 8 minus 6 is 2. I cannot subtract 5 minus 8, so I need to borrow from my 4. This becomes a 3. This becomes a 15. 15 minus 8 is 7. 3 minus 0 is 3. So that means your final difference is 372 and 8 hundredths. With that, we have concluded our interactive notebook page for this week on adding and subtracting decimals. I'll see y'all next week. Bye.